Welcome, friends. Welcome back to the kitchen. Today, out on the pellet grill, I have brown sugar rubbed chicken on the go. And I'm also doing a cheesy potato dish, a scalloped potato or a potato gratin with bacon and cream. And I thought I'd do a roasted cauliflower to go with it. And I'm going to do this under high heat in the oven. And the main flavorings are going to be lemon and Parmesan. I think it's really good. So the first thing I'm going to do is cut up this cauliflower, get it dressed. And I like to cut the florets fairly small. That way it roasts instead of steaming, and you get a nice caramelized dark coating on the outside that tastes amazing. Probably only going to use half of this cauliflower, so I'll just cut some of these florets out and see how we go. Okay, I think this is the last floret I'm going to cut up because that looks like about enough. So I'm going to put this all into a big bowl. Get it all in there. And I'm gonna put on some olive oil. You can use any neutral oil if you want. It doesn't have to be olive oil. And sprinkle in some salt. Crack in some pepper. And then I'm gonna juice in half of this lemon. And I will pull the seeds out. Not a big deal. Don't get all worked up about it. Now, you need to play this by eye. You need to look at it and say, should I add a little bit more lemon juice? Should I add a little bit more oil? Give it a toss, see if you can coat it all. And there's a point where you don't want too much because, again, you don't want it to steam when it goes in the oven. You want it to roast. And I think we're good. I think half of that lemon was enough. I think we're coated. So I'm gonna put on Parm. You can put on any hard cheese, aged hard cheese that you like. I'm going to use Parm. You could use Pecorino. There's a whole bunch of other cheeses. For this dish, I'm not looking for necessarily a cheese that's melty. I'm looking for a cheese that's going to add an incredible amount of flavor. And I'm going to put about half of the amount on now, toss it in and roast it with it. And the other half of the amount I'm going to put on when it comes out of the oven. So I'll give that a toss. And then drop it into the pan. And this is a cast iron pan, goes in the oven, everything is great. Okay, try to do a single layer. So again, it roasts and doesn't steam. The oven is preheated to 475. So I'm gonna stick it in, and at about the 20 minute mark, I'm gonna give it a stir so that they mix around nicely and get roasty on all sides. And then every 5 minutes or so, I'm gonna check it, make sure that it doesn't burn.
Ooh, look at that. Hey, Glen.
Hey, Jules.
Hey, friends. Okay, so I just walked past the pellet grill. Smelled really great, but that's not...
Don't look at the pellet grill. We're having this first.
That's not this.
No. So I've got a couple of forks. So I'm going to put just a little bit of more Parm on after it's cooked.
Because how do you make anything better but add more cheese?
Add more cheese! More cheese! Okay, so this isn't going to be much of a surprise because we trialed this at dinner last night.
So I'm curious, what changes did you decide to make? Because we talked about a few different opportunities.
So we cooked this last night in the gas oven in our house, which is a forced fan oven. We just got a forced fan oven. We're like the last people on the planet, apparently, which I don't have out here. So I used a higher temperature out here because the temperature difference is a little bit different.
Okay.
I put in a little bit more lemon juice. I was on the fence about putting in some lemon zest.
Okay, because I found the lemon was really great yesterday.
Was really great yesterday. I did add a little bit more cheese.
Okay.
Cheese at the end. And I didn't change it much because I thought it was pretty
good. It was really good. It was really good. It's still really good.
You could add like maybe some thyme, some fresh thyme or fresh rosemary.
You could add whatever flavors you like. As always, yeah. Add what you like.
But I'd put the thyme and the rosemary in maybe about 5 minutes before the dish is done so that it doesn't burn. Because if the herbs burn, they get a little bit bitter. But I think that is an amazing side dish.
I like it.
I like it.
I'm in.
Okay. So come on back because this is just the beginning of a three-parter.
Clearly it's going to go with something from the
So we've got a smoked potato gratin, or some people call it a scalloped potato, even though it has cheese in it. So that's coming next, and then we've got that
more cheese,
brown sugar rubbed chicken. So come on back for both of those. Thanks for stopping by. See you again soon.